Good afternoon, and welcome to the Berwick Area Senior High School's 2020 commencement ceremony, the adjusted, abridged, adapted, and revised version. On behalf of the entire faculty and staff, I would like to thank everyone for their support and understanding. We really hope to make this a special and memorable event for you all. At this time, I would ask that everyone please stand for the playing of our national anthem, and please remain standing for the invocation delivered by our senior class secretary, Kelsey Kalady.
Coaches, parents, parents, families, and friends for helping us reach this important milestone. Through our 4 years here, we made new friends, joined clubs, became a part of a team, and tried new things outside of our comfort zones. Today is the last time any of us will see each other, well, until our class reunion starts. At BHS, we've all shared some great memories from football games to class exams, junior prom, and being part of the first musical. We even set a new school record for the longest senior skip day, thanks COVID-19. Like many of you, I'm upset we did not get a proper graduation, senior prom, and senior trip. But in years to come, we will remember how unique our graduation is and what we still graduated despite the circumstances. We are a strong class, born during the terrorist attacks of 9/11 and graduating during the pandemic. It feels unreal. It feels like yesterday we were in elementary school playing outside for recess with our friends. Now here we stand today, ready to walk across the stage and leave this chapter of our lives behind us, and head out to make new friends and memories wherever we may end up. Today is all about us, and all that we have done to get to the stage in our lives. I want to say congratulations and well done for reaching this accomplishment that some do not receive. I know it was not easy, and that sometimes you felt like giving up, but you should be proud of your past self for persevering and toughing it out through those uncertain times. As you graduate today, remember the feeling of happiness and relief flood through your body. It should serve as a reminder that you can achieve anything you put your mind to. As Nike said, don't ask if your dreams are crazy. Ask if they're crazy enough. Challenge yourself to accomplish those crazy dreams. Do what makes you happy and never settle for something you do not want. As we venture out into the world as young adults, we may not know what our path is, but I believe there's a plan set in motion for all of us. The beginning of your next chapter starts tomorrow. And wherever it may take you, I hope you succeed and cannot wait to hear about your adventures in 5 years. So strive for those crazy dreams that no one believes you will achieve and show them what it means to be a bulldog. Good luck and God bless.
Thank you, Sydney. Graduates, I hope the last four years have been a positive experience for you. I'm sure this is not how you envision the ending. This is certainly not a typical commencement ceremony. But so often in life, you will find that things that are not typical have many silver linings and can open doors you never even knew existed. You have earned this day, so cherish it. Today is not only a special day for you, your parents and family members share in the joy and excitement of this moment as well. At this time, I would like to have all the parents, guardians, and family members of all graduating seniors stand so that we can thank you publicly for your support and dedication throughout your child's educational journey. I would like to now ask Senior Class Vice President Madeline Eisenberg to come to the stage for a special tribute.
Thank you.
Thank you, Maddie. This year, two graduating seniors have been asked to share their thoughts with the class of 2020. I would like to call forward our salutatorian, Sydney Lloyd, and our valedictorian, Sydney Kimball. Sydney Lloyd will speak first, to be followed by Sydney Kimball.
Welcome, classmates, faculty, parents, family, and friends. I am Sydney Lloyd, and it is with great honor that I welcome you to Berwick Class of 2020 Graduation Ceremony. To my classmates, I want to say congratulations. After 13 long years, we finally did it. Throughout the many late nights and early mornings of studying, practicing sports and music, or long shifts at work, we can say that it finally paid off in the end. Today, you are here because you had a goal to accomplish, whether that is to graduate the top of your class or just to graduate and get up. I know that you worked hard to get where you are today. Today is about you. Remember this one. We only get one high school graduation. Wherever the future may take you after today, the workforce, military, or college, I wish you luck. I hope that you succeed in every part of your life. Remember, once a bulldog, always a bulldog. To the faculty and staff, thank you for dealing with our class these last 4 years. When we left on March 13th, we expected to come back to school and go through the rest of high school like every class before us. However, COVID-19 had different plans for us. So today, we get to say a proper goodbye to you. Thank you for teaching us the curriculum that was required, but most importantly, thank you for teaching us life lessons that we will carry with us. There is one teacher in particular that I would like to thank for helping me these past 2 years, Mr. Schrader. Not only did you let me sleep on your floor when I was sick, but you also got me out of my comfort zone by making me participate in disc golf. You were always there when I needed help, and I'm hoping I passed your AP test since I know you were stressed about it. Thank you to the faculty and staff who helped us all graduate. I know you all have a bunch of memories with the students. Without you, we may not have succeeded. To the parents, families, and friends that are here today, thank you for pushing us to be our best selves and for helping us get to this stage in our lives. With your constructive criticism and support, we get to stand here today and call ourselves graduates. I want to give a special shout out to my parents who dealt with my emotional breakdowns, fixed every paper I wrote, and for coming to all my sporting events. It meant the world to me. Thank you for giving me the love and support I needed throughout high school. You helped me get to where I am today and made me a better person along the way. This should go to all the parents too. So thank you to all the parents, families, and friends for being here today. It means the world to us that you could be here to celebrate our special day. The class of 2020 has faced many difficult situations throughout high school, but the worst was not being able to go back to school one last time. As we left school on Friday, March 13th, we did not expect to never be able to walk the halls of the building again. The last few months of high school, the best few months, were taken away from us in the blink of an eye. From this, I think we all learned a valuable lesson. We need to live more in the present. We should be out, having fun, living life to the fullest, because we never know when our last moment will be. So I challenge you, class of 2020, to seek more adventures, get outside your comfort zone, and most importantly, just have fun. On that note, I hope you achieve your dreams and become everything you want to be. I'm rooting for you. Thank you.
Absolute pleasure of spending 24 hours a day with family, even our siblings that may have now a part of history. You'll be the most remembered senior class despite not having a traditional graduation ceremony. Even though it was one day uncertain whether we would walk across the stage in our cap and gown or listen to Berwick Band playing Pomp and Circumstance, it is still a time of celebration. So why is it so important to wear a cap and gown even during a non-traditional ceremony? Academics have been celebrated throughout history, and as early as the 12th century, graduates wore a cap and gown to separate themselves from the rest of society and to symbolize their achievements. We, as the class of 2020, can not only use our cap and gowns to distinguish ourselves, but our shared experiences over the past 13 years. In elementary school, we communicated online through games like Webkinz or Club Penguin. By middle school, we were creating our first social media accounts on Instagram, posting now embarrassing images of every aspect of our daily lives. Currently, we not only use social media to communicate and stay in touch with each other, but we use platforms like Zoom and Google Meet to learn virtually. Because of this, we are the most prepared generation to thrive in this isolated setting. In elementary school, our only worries were who started as it while playing tag at recess. By the time we got to middle school, as we began to connect with the world through technology, we feared rumors that the world was ending in 2012. But I think the Lions may have miscalculated that a bit because they didn't have Mr. Guthrie for math. As high school comes to an end, we are worried that our everyday lives will look like in the future as things are rapidly changing. Life will always have its worries, but we will be the ones to find the solutions. In elementary school, we listened to the radio as our parents took us to school and enjoyed songs like Gangnam Style and the Harlem Shake during the 14th Street PSSA party. In middle school, we used Pandora to listen to songs like Happy by Pharrell over and over and over again. Then by the time we got to high school, we used Spotify, making every type of music available at our fingertips. Throughout the duration of our lives, we have constantly embraced the development of technology, eagerly switching from MySpace to TikTok, which entertains us day and night. Although it is important to take the time to celebrate ourselves, we must also remember to take the time to thank those who have helped us get here. I am fortunate enough to use this time to publicly thank those who have helped me. Please remember to personally thank those who have helped each one of you. I would like to thank my parents for constantly nagging me to study and complete my homework, which I ignored 90% of the time, but the 10% I listened to probably paid off a little bit. I would like to thank my brother for giving me a good example of how to successfully put off work as long as possible, which I mastered, achieving a higher class rank because he was only second in his class. I hope this speech will be as successful as his 2017 speech. I would like to thank my grandmother for getting me to elementary school 20 minutes early every day and for allowing me to develop my love of fonts by playing with her only game on the computer, Microsoft Word. Next, I would like to thank my friends who are always there during good and bad times. Whether we were working on schoolwork together at 4 a.m., celebrating each other's sports accomplishments, comforting each other through loss, or just enjoying each other's company, I'm confident to say I have incredible friends I can always count on. I would like to thank Amy Daniel for her patience, dedication, and knowledge that allowed me to not embarrass myself on the field hockey field, even though I did not know how to hold a stick on the first day of practice. Finally, I, as many of you, have many teachers to thank. First, I would like to thank Mr. Allen for leaving his window open, giving us fresh air and the occasional visiting bird. The events that followed may have not been fortunate for the bird, but they give me a good laugh to this day. I would like to thank Ms. Rothery for teaching us cellular respiration way more in depth than we would ever have wished, and for taking me to Costa Rica, where I learned how to surf and talk my way out of getting stuck in airport security when I almost missed the flight. I would like to thank Mrs. Reinhardt for developing me both as a musician and as a person from the time that I did not even know how to put a clarinet together. I would like to thank Mr. Owinger, despite his constant accusation of me running the Berwick Band Meet account, which I did not run, for helping me continue my love of music and reach my goals. On behalf of the whole band, thank you for putting up with all of us. Westchester will be lucky to have you. I would like to thank Mr. Gunther for not only coaching the regional championship winning math counts team and taking us out for fast food despite some incidents, but also for his willingness to help as a teacher, even helping start my AP research project at 9 p.m. the day before it was due. In addition, I would like to thank all the other people that have worked with me from elementary school through high school. From counselors and teaching staff to administrators and the school board, Berwick is an outstanding school district. Although we are treating this as the end, this is just the beginning of our lives. But with great power comes great responsibility, as we now have the autonomy to decide the path that our future takes. Not only must we decide our own path, but now we have the obligation to use what we have learned here at Berwick High School to better the world around us. I have no doubt in my mind that we are capable of great things. Back in our middle school days, we were able to come together as a class to address a cafeteria issue. Hashtag pack it up. Just imagine what we can accomplish now and in the future. Whether continuing your education, going into the workforce, or serving our country, our combined successes will set us apart from the classes before us. Not because we are the class of the coronavirus, but because we are the class that will succeed in spite of the coronavirus. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Thank you, Sydney and Sydney. At this time, I would like to call senior class advisors to the podium. Mrs. Bernadette DePippa and Mrs. Annette Eisenberg, please come forward. Advisors recognize the candidates for diplomas before you as having completed the necessary requirements for graduation from the Berwick Area Senior High School. Thank you. Our final speaker will be class treasurer, John Weston Arndt, to deliver the benediction.
Teachers, family, my fellow classmates, today signifies the end of a chapter in our lives and the beginning of another. As you graduate today, may our class of 2020 strive towards excellence in all that we do. May our spirits guide us as we continue to better the world around us. May God inspire us to believe in the goodness of life, even when faced with challenges and difficulties. As we commence with our lives, may we grow ever more grateful and wise. We thank God for watching over us and bringing us to this important moment. We thank you for the opportunity to continue to learn and grow. We thank you for all the friends we have made, memories we have created, and for all the times of great discovery and learning. May God be with us all, guiding us each day, in hope of achieving a better future. Amen.
Thank you, Weston. It is now time for the presentation of diplomas. That responsibility belongs to the President of the School Board of Education, Mrs. Susie Wiegand. Cody Ryan Albertson. John Weston Arndt. Julia Renee Arnold. Set Ayala. Logan William Babb. Kyle Anthony Bale. Danielle Nicole Baker. Brianna Marie Ballia.
Hey, Brianna! Hello!
Shelby Allen Walter. Tyler William Bankus. Antonio Andre Barada. Tyler Edward Baum. Miranda Michelle Bedwell. Haley Marguerite Bijouet. Jenna Eleanor Bird. Dylan Michael Bogart. Victoria Grace Bogart. Gage Andrew Quartz. Kelsey Marie Budman. Kylan Boyer. Daniel Christopher Brown. Oliver Thomas Brown. Kelsey Loretta Kalady. Francisco Alexander Cardenas Lemus. Mitchell Cashman. Mark Samuel Salona. Alexander Paul Seminaro. Robert James Chase Jr. Thank you. Gabrielle Marina Chaudhry. Jacob Matthew Collins Fuller. Morgan Ray Cooper. Noah Andrew Craig. Dia Naomi Cruz. Peter Gilberto. Madison Noel Day. Katrina Lenady Demko. Sarah Rebecca Dent. Miriam Grace DiAgostino. Reese Jacob DiAgostino. Gabriel Christopher DePippa. Mia Elizabeth Dahl. Luis Andres Denaire. Andrew P. Elfrick. Paige Emma Lee Fenton. Grayson Tyler Farrell. Russell Mauer Feder III. Nicholas Richard Feudale. Derek Michael Fink. Tiffany Ann Faust. Carter Lee Fowler. Kristen Sarah Fulton. Brandon Tyler Lucas Guys. Maximus Raymond Harmon. Cheyenne Ray Harrison. Nicholas Scott Heimball. Madison Faith Hilliard. Alexis Paige Hinckley. Alexis Eliza Hunsinger. Keegan Riley Hunter. Yolanda Elizabeth Irahita. Nicholas Shane Paulzak. Madeline Grace Eisenberg. Dustin Paul Jaffe. Nicia L. Justine. Riley Christopher Johnson. Janae C. Carnes. Sydney Elizabeth Grace Kimball. Maddie Renee Kishball. Jenvin Cade Moore. Joseph David Lipinski. Ryan Curtis Lawball. Olivia Duval Learn. Sydney Sue Lloyd. Michael James Lombardo. Junior. Seth Hunter Mattis. Gabriel Robert McCarr. Martelli. Richard Mason. Jaden Michelle Michael. Yara Rose Nikolowski. Juliana Jean Morris. Thank you. Isabel Lily Ann O'Donnell. David Michael Pace. Lacey Lynn Pollock. Natalia Marie Pasquale. Javier Perla. Dustin Michael Peters. Gianni Paul Popko. Shania Janelle Powell. Sean Jason Powell. Archer Stephen Quick. Zachary Ryan Reba. Destiny Ann Reed. Katrina Lynette Ramsey. Benjamin Harold Rexroth. Mitchell Gregory Riley. Colton Lee Ryder. Preston Scott Robbins. Arlene Esmeralda Romero. Dominic Bernard Rummel. Ronald Damon Samsel III. Amy Jeanette Sanchez. Anastasia Nicole Shuckley. Dallas Michael Shuckley. Gavin Joseph Scott. Callie Ann Seferin. Levi Brian Siegfried. Rachel Marie Shafto. Griffin Thomas Schreckenberg. Cisco. Sullivan Albert Slavinsky. Maxwell Lane Slusser. Stephen Isaac Smith. Trinity Michaela Sockrider. Marquesa Christine Steinrock. Trent Everett Strother.
We're so proud of you.
Riley Lynn Stryker. Edward Peter Fowler. Madison Elizabeth Titus. Isabella Contessa Trapani. Gage Michael Traw. Haley Ann Marie Trall. Courtney Brianne Taroski. Mackenzie Lynn Van Sibble. Anthony Jose Vasquez. Connor James McCloskey. Anthony Joseph Ventura. Marissa Ann Clark. Leah Mackenzie Watts. Mattia Christine Weaver. Kayla Lynn Weaver. Justin Tyler Whitebread. Allison Paige Zagato. Joseph David Lipinski. Ladies and gentlemen, I proudly present to you the Berwick Area Youth Senior High School Class of 2020. Thank you, enjoy the day, and stay safe and healthy.